sahabat KBRI BSB, tahukah kamu bahwa Indonesia adalah penghasil kopi terbesar keempat di dunia? Ada tiga macam biji kopi yang tumbuh di Indonesia, yaitu biji kopi Arabica, biji kopi Robusta, dan biji kopi Liberica. Dari letak geografis, iklim maupun tanahnya, Indonesia sangat ideal untuk tumbuhan kopi. Dengan seluruh perpaduan ini, berbagai specialty kopi Indonesia telah mencuri hati penggemar kopi mancanegara, seperti kopi Gayo, kopi Sumatera, kopi Lampung, kopi Banten, kopi Jawa, kopi Pasuruan, kopi Banyuwangi, kopi Bali, kopi Flores, kopi Toraja, kopi Pinogu, kopi Minahasa, dan kopi Papua. KBRI BSB ingin memperkenalkan kopi Indonesia kepada masyarakat Brunei. Budaya minum kopi dan pergi ke kafe mulai menjadi gaya hidup masyarakat Brunei, termasuk anak mudanya. Sahabat baru kita, Batch Coffee, bersedia untuk memberikan honest review dua specialty coffee dari Indonesia kali ini. Yuk, mari kita simak video mereka berikut ini.
Hi there, we're Batch's Coffee. I'm Ku, this is Fida.
Hi.
We're a small cafe based in Kulab, Brunei Darussalam, and today we're here to taste two different coffees from Indonesia.
These beans were gifted to us by Indonesian Embassy. These beans were roasted by Mad Bottle Coffee. They are based at Surakarta, Jawa Tengah. That is somewhere in Yogyakarta.
Cool.
So we've got two different beans, which is the Flores Manggarai. This was processed in an anaerobic wash process and roasted as a medium profile. Other than that, it is their local variety of a Kartika 2, I think. Yeah, so local product of Indonesia itself.
What about the other bean?
The other one is the Toraja Pulu Pulu, dry hulled. It's medium processed.
Alright, cool.
Same thing, it is a local variety, which is the Lini S795. So today we will be brewing these two on filter. We'll be using the origami dripper, using the 4-6 method of Tetsu Kaisuya method.
So, let's get to brewing. All right, so great. Now we have both our beans brewed, and let's get into tasting. But just before that, let's have a smell of the beans, and maybe you can explain to you a little bit more.
Okay, let's go with the Toraja Pulu Pulu first. That's how they packaged it. To me, it smells a lot more like chocolate.
Well, it's a very, very dark chocolate sort of smell, very earthy chocolate.
Yeah.
Very nice, very nice. Something I personally prefer.
Something like, it's a very morning cup of coffee.
Very typical Indonesian style.
Let's get to tasting.
This smells like what you'd expect a coffee to smell like when you wake up. Very medium roastish, very dark, heavy body.
There is no acidity to it though.
No, which is good.
Yeah. Although in their little note this says high acidity, but no. Maybe it's the brewing method. I'd enjoy this in the morning.
Yeah.
Just to
Very good. I mean, I think this caters to a lot of people's sort of palate for when it comes to coffee.
I think this is the Bruneian mass palate when it comes to coffee, actually.
Could be,
it's like where it's thick in body and there's the taste to them probably is like coffee taste. like very chocolatey, very caramel, like yeah, very nice.
Want to move on to the other Flores?
Yep.
Cool.
Let's go with that. But what I'm expecting from the Flores, since it's an anaerobic wash, is more fermenty.
Hmm.
This is very fruity to me. It smells very fruity.
I think the anaerobic process really made a difference in how this roast came out.
It's sweet as well.
Yeah, it smells a lot sweeter, a little bit more tea-like.
I think so too. Oh, it's like fruity, it's like there's like mango-ish to it, that kind of note for me.
Definitely a big difference compared to the other bean which we had, which was the
Thuraja.
Yeah. Two different processes, two different beans.
Yeah, but this one, I enjoy this one. It's more towards my preference of a palate.
Very nice. I mean, I'm loving how there's this much variety coming from Indonesian beans, whereas you have something a little bit more darker, heavy body, things that people expect to taste from coffee. And also we have a lighter, more tea-like, a little bit more complicated in terms of processes. There's just so much flavor that's coming out of Indonesia.
Yeah. And I guess it's because as well that they are one of the biggest producer in ASEAN for coffee.
I enjoyed what I tasted today.
And thank you to Indonesian Embassy for the opportunity to taste these coffee beans. And I hope that we can actually get them brought in to Brunei very soon.
Awesome. Thanks for watching this video.
See you guys. Stay safe.
Bye.
Sekian video tentang kopi Indonesia kali ini. Tunggu dan saksikan video-video tentang kopi Indonesia selanjutnya.